Today we're going to talk about Morbius. So let's get cracking! Hello, all my explorers, and welcome back to Loren's Adventures Out There. And if you are new, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. My name is Loren, and I'm with Castle Capes and Clones, where we discuss everything in the Disney universe. We do unboxings, hauls, pins, box swaps, Disney news, Disney reviews, and more. So if that sounds fun to you, we'd love it if you would subscribe to our channel, hit that bell for notification. And do like this post, as it really does help us out. So yesterday, with much apprehension, I went to go see Morbius. The reviews on this film have been horrible, but before I get to what I felt about the film, let me just tell you a little bit about it. First of all, it is a Marvel, based on a Marvel comic character named Morbius, the living vampire, who is part of the kind of Spider-Man universe of Marvel. And he was created, I think, in the 70s, and he had this real glam rock look, and I always kind of liked Morbius and the way that he looked. Anyway, this film is not part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. It is not produced by Marvel Studios, so everybody should go into this prepared, if you are a Marvel fan, knowing this does not have to do with the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This is part of Sony's Spider-Man universe. And from what I understand, this Morbius exists in the same universe as Venom, so which is another Marvel film that is produced by Sony rather than Marvel Studios. Dr. Michael Morbius, is an acclaimed doctor who has worked his entire life to cure blood diseases. He creates an artificial blood that has saved millions of lives. And the reason why he's done this is because he has a rare blood disease that really affects his autoimmune system. And when he was younger, he had also a friend named Milo, who had the same disease, and he pledged to cure them both. Somehow it leads him to Costa Rica, where he conducts an experiment with vampire bats. Anyway, the experiment seems to cure his blood disease, but at the same time, he starts becoming a living vampire, where he starts craving blood. At first he's like this killer that he's feeding on people, but he really wants to keep everything under control. He wants to drink artificial blood. At the same time, he has also conducted this experiment on his friend Milo. This is, of course, years later from when they were boys. Milo, though, wants to embrace being a vampire, and he has no guilt in feeding off of other people. So Morbius tries to stop his friend. The two kind of on opposite sides, where Morbius is more of a heroic character. And anyway, that's where we are. I won't tell you the ending. But yeah, I I don't know if my expectations were super low because of all the reviews about it, but I had a fun time. I'm not saying it was a great film. I thought it was like a nice popcorn film to see on a weekend afternoon. But I'm really not sure what they could have done to this film to make it better. You know, obviously they wanted Morbius to be more on the heroic side and needed a villain to that he could fight. That's where it was just predictable. Like, I could have predicted the fact that his friend would be the villain in the film. And it's sad. I do want any Marvel film to succeed. And I just don't think that Sony knows what to do with its Spider-Man characters. And it's coming out with a Kraven the Hunter film. Kraven is one of my favorite Spider-Man villains. And I'm afraid of what they're going to do with this character. Because I eventually want, and I know that it's going to take a while, but Marvel will eventually get the Spider-Man universe back. It's inevitable. They will get them back. But right now it's a cash cow for Sony, so they will hold on to it as long as they can. The part of the film, though, that irked me the most was the ending of the film, the very ending of the film into the post-credits. I won't spoil anything. Like, it tries to build this universe, but in the weirdest way, and part of it really makes me angry, but it also doesn't make any sense at the same time. I'll leave it to you to see if you can make any sense of the ending, but for me, it's an ending that just really kind of makes me mad and left me confused. And I wish that they hadn't done that. Much has been said about the action sequences, just heavily CGI action sequences, and I have to admit, I kind of liked it. As my sister said to me as we were leaving the theater, she said that she enjoyed these scenes as well because it reminded her of like what she would see in a comic book. And I thought the same thing. It felt very comic booky. You know, it's just very different. I personally enjoy a more, you know, physical, less CGI action sequences, the kind that Marvel Studios does. But for the most part, just within this own movie, I thought that it was fun. I thought that the action sequences were fun. I thought that they, as my sister said, were very comic booky. So anyway, I, you know, leave it to you to judge this film. Like, I try not to let early reviews influence me, because oftentimes I disagree. Like with this film, I'm disagreeing. I'm not saying that this film is great, but I'm also not saying that this film is as terrible as many of the reviews I've seen. If you do decide to watch this movie, let me know in the comments below, or let me know if you're intending to watch this movie. I really want to know what your opinions of the film are. Anyway, that is it for our review. If you enjoyed this review, We'd love it if you would subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Hit that bell for notifications. And do like this post, as it really does help us out. Visit us on all of our socials down below. Visit our website at www.castlescapesandclones.com. Thank you so much, and we will see you later. Bye!